All right, and we are live on Facebook. So good morning, PT on Ice Daily Show. This is Dr. Jordan Berry, lead faculty for cervical spine and lumbar spine management courses. It's Tuesday, it's Clinical Tuesday. Our topic is the expert therapist treats one region. Okay, I wanna spend just a few minutes unpacking that this morning. Before we get into that, just wanna mention a couple live courses that we've got coming up over the next couple weeks. So this weekend, August 7th and 8th, we've got Rehab of the Injured Runner. It's down at SST Rehab in Orlando, Florida. Also this weekend coming up, August 7th and 8th, we've got Cervical Spine Management down at Delta Physical Therapy in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. And then 2 weeks from now, August 14th and 15th, we've got Clinical Management of the Fitness Athlete Live down at CrossFit 845 in Wappingers Falls, New York. All right, so let's dive in. Clinical Tuesday, again, the expert therapist treats one region. All right, I wanna unpack that just for about 10 minutes this morning. So I wanna talk about a clinical concept that comes up quite often in the live course, in lumbar spine management and cervical spine management. And during the live course, we spend a good amount of time and have a really strong emphasis that during the objective exam, we need to know how to rule in or out regions. Okay, for example, that patient that comes in that's got pain in their back, maybe some pain in the posterior lateral hip, and maybe some pain in the anterior hip as well. Okay, so we've got multiple regions that have symptoms. Our goal, day one, during the objective exam is to figure out what is the primary symptom generator. Okay, so I'm gonna give you an example body chart on that patient that I'm talking about. Okay, I've drawn it out here. If you're on if you're listening on the podcast and you can't see this, the body chart is exactly what I've just said. So we've got a patient that's got pain in the lumbar spine here, it's our P1. We've got some pain in the posterior lateral hip as well. And then as well in the anterior hip, all that being on the same side, okay? So three different pain areas or pain regions. Now, I would encourage you as you're going through your subjective exam and we know that body chart, we're gonna develop an initial hypothesis list. Just thinking about what could be going on with that patient. Okay, so a few hypotheses could be maybe just mechanical low back pain. Okay, we could have some maybe extra articular hip pain. Most likely that's going to be like some form of tendinopathy or maybe some intra-articular hip pain, like in that anterior hip on the right side as well. So we've got a few different hypotheses on board as to what could be driving that person's symptoms. So then during the objective exam, we are going to try to rule in or out regions to prove or disprove those competing hypotheses to wind up with a working hypothesis. Right, the working hypothesis being where we think the symptoms are coming from, the primary symptom generator. Now, sometimes during the objective exam on a patient like what I just described, it's really easy, right? Let's say we go right after the hip and we're able to rule out the hip. So we do all of the things that we teach in the lumbar spine management course that you need to do to rule out the hip. Nothing shows up, but when we go to the low back, we find some relevant symptoms and actually provoke all of those pain areas, right? So we would rule in the lumbar spine and then go after that and treat that day one. Okay, now, anyone that's treating patients in the clinic knows that oftentimes it's not that simple and it's not that clean. So sometimes during the objective exam on that patient, let's say we're doing active range of motion for the lumbar spine and we bring on some familiar symptoms as well as during the segmental exam. And then we go have a look at the hip, maybe hip passive range of motion and palpation to a certain area also reproduce familiar symptoms. So we've basically ruled in both of those regions. So then the million dollar question becomes, early on, like in day one, when we're trying to create a meaningful change, increase patient expectation, what region do we treat first? That question comes up all the time in the live course. Okay, a few thoughts on this. I don't think it's nearly as important what region we treat day one as it is to only treat one region on day one. So on that patient that I was describing, I don't think it's nearly as important if you treated the back or the hip day one. What I think is important though is that you don't treat both. Okay, so let me give you a few reasons why I want to make that argument. Okay, number one, we want to be able to increase our pattern recognition. Okay, so pattern recognition is basically just becoming more efficient with treating a specific pattern the more times that you see it. Okay, it allows you to go from A to B to D and skipping C because you're so familiar with that pattern because you've seen it so much in the clinic. Now, let's say that you treated multiple areas on that patient day one. If you do that, you have sabotaged your ability to create a clean pattern for that patient, regardless if they come back better or not. That's the kicker. Because let's say that you manipulate the lumbar spine and you mobilize the hip day one, and they come back visit two and they feel significantly better, even though that's a good thing, right? We always want the patient coming back feeling better. But now you have no idea which one was truly driving more of their symptoms and driving that person's pain response. So yes, you've made them feel better, you've changed their symptoms, but you've done nothing to increase your efficiency when you see that pattern again in the future. Now, on the other hand, let's say that you only treated the lumbar spine day one, and that person comes back visit two, and they're significantly better, and that includes a greater, let's say a 50% pain reduction in that right anterior hip pain. Now, during day one, you actually thought that was coming from the hip, like intra-articular hip pain. But since you only treated the back on day one, you now know that the lumbar spine was driving a significant amount of that person's symptoms. You would never know that if you treated both on day one. Or let's say they come back and there actually isn't much symptom behavior change, right? So not a lot of progress from visit one to two. Now, it's not ideal, but it's still gonna help you develop that pattern. Because if you only treated the low back and they come back and there's not much change, now you know that most likely the hip is what's driving the majority of the symptoms. So now we can dial in and go to that on day two. But the point is, if you only treat one region, you now know exactly what's driving the symptoms, and you're not going to miss it on the second or third or fourth time that you see that presentation in the clinic. Okay, so that's number one. Number two is patient compliance. Okay, patient compliance regarding, you know, their HEP or what they're doing outside of your clinic is challenging no matter what setting you're in. So my goal with a patient's HEP is always to try to keep it as simple and straightforward as possible, okay, in order to maximize compliance. By only treating one region, you can take that time that you would have devoted to treating the second region to really dialing in the HEP, right? Like how many sets, how many reps, at what tempo, what level of fatigue are we gonna work towards? What level of pain is acceptable? How many times per day, right? All of those variables around a person's HEP, we can spend much more time dialing that in. Think about the two examples. Like let's say we're treating a lumbar or a lateral hip tendinopathy. There is a significant difference by the last 1 or 2 minutes of a session saying, John, I want you to knock out these couple exercises a few times during your workday, as opposed to saying, John, what we're going to do is focus on loading your hip over the next week. I want you to focus on this one exercise, the single leg step up that we went over. Okay, you're going to do it once per day, holding a 35-pound kettlebell on the opposite side, two sets of 12 reps, with a 3-second concentric and a 3-second eccentric on each rep, and no more than 5 out of 10 pain is allowed during the movement or over the 24-hour period following the exercise. Those two are dramatically different. Love how Steve Short says, if we're gonna treat exercise like medicine, we've gotta prescribe it like that. Okay, so the more simple but specific you can be with your HEP, I think the higher your compliance rate is gonna be. All right, and the last one. We're selling the next session, okay? So we are in sales as physical therapists. Like it or not, we are in sales. It doesn't matter how skilled of a therapist you are if your patient doesn't come back to see you. So I'm always thinking about how can we sell the next session. So if you're thinking about which region to treat day one, again, it doesn't necessarily matter which you choose. It just matters that you treat one, because you're gonna have more time and you're gonna sell the next session by telling your patient what we're gonna focus on over the next few sessions. So for that patient that I described, like when I'm in the clinic, it might sound something like this. Okay, I say, John, I think some of your symptoms are actually coming from your back and some are coming from your hip. So what I wanna do today is intentionally only treat your back. So over the next week, we can figure out exactly how much of the symptoms you're having are coming from the back. And that'll help guide our treatment moving forward. If I treat both of them today, we're gonna have no clue at the next session how to move forward. So if you come back on visit two and we see a really big change in your symptoms, we're gonna hammer the low back for the next few visits. But on the other hand, if we don't see as significant of a change or as significant as what we would have expected, we'll most likely change gears and jump over to the hip and treat that area. But either way, we're gonna have a game plan on how to move forward. Okay, so now your patient knows exactly what's gonna happen at the next session, and they're gonna bring you back a lot of relevant information that's gonna guide that next session. So now they know it's not just gonna be the same thing you did last time, right? You're gonna use the information that they're bringing back to guide treatment on the next session. Okay, so I think those are the three main reasons why the expert treats only one region early on in the plan of care. So when you're in the clinic and when you've got that patient where you've ruled in multiple areas and you're not sure whether to go to the hip or whether to go to the back or whatever the regions are, choose one and commit to it. And you're gonna see your decision making become so much more clear. Your pattern recognition is gonna skyrocket, and your patient compliance will massively increase. Okay, the expert therapist does significantly less in the clinic, but they do it better. One way that you do it better is that you only treat one region early on in the plan of care. All right, so I would love to hear any thoughts on this. If you've got any questions, thoughts, concerns, drop them in the comments and we'll have a good conversation about it. Other than that, have an awesome Tuesday in the clinic. If you're gonna be at a cervical or lumbar management course live anytime soon, I will probably see you there. All right, have a great day in the clinic.
Hey, thanks for tuning in to the PT on Ice Daily Show. If you enjoyed this content, head on over to iTunes and leave us a review. And be sure to check us out on Facebook and Instagram at the Institute of Clinical Excellence. If you're interested in getting plugged into more ICE content on a weekly basis while earning CEUs from home, check out our virtual ICE online mentorship program at ptonice.com. While you're there, sign up for our Hump Day Hustling newsletter for a free email every Wednesday morning with our top 5 research articles and social media posts that we think are worth reading. Head over to ptonice.com and scroll to the bottom of the page to sign up.